Good day. My name is Dr. Alvin Auerbach-White. I'm a senior lecturer at Swansea University. I'm at the Energy Safety Research Institute and the Department of Chemical Engineering. Plus, I'm the founder of Trent Labs Limited. My research area deals with the creation and use of nanomaterials for a sustainable energy future. On the one hand, I make nanomaterials due to their beneficial properties. They're lightweight, they've got high strength, and they have thermal data and electrical conduction properties. Well, on the other hand, I look to the future to see where they'll be best used, and also, how will they be made in a sustainable manner? After all, there is no planet B. So, I will outline the science behind my process, and I'll highlight some recently published results. I will also discuss the need to move from the lab bench to the marketplace. Ideas are great, but real solutions need to be accessible to a wider audience beyond academia. Having participated at the Royal Society Parliamentary Pairing Scheme, I can say firsthand that policy matters. For example, at a previous conference, I heard one inventor say they spent 25 years perfecting their solution to the plastics crisis, only to then realize that it was the policy landscape holding them back. There are two policy areas that have become self-evident to me through my research and entrepreneurship. They are policy for incentivizing spending on innovation and research, and insurance policy. Science research requires effort and money to fund that effort. Corporate innovation takes time away from core business practices, and this has additional costs in terms of time and money. So sometimes it doesn't pay to innovate, and companies need to stay solvent to stay open. So policy in this area could free up human capital and in businesses and incentivize spending on research institutes such as Swansea University. So we could work towards the innovative solutions, the kinds we need now. But even if you do create an innovative solution, you may not get insurance, especially in the area of recycling. We've seen lots of great examples from governments enacting positive recycling policies. But in reality, it is very hard to do work in this space because insurance companies are hesitant to underwrite the work. Without insurance, these ideas are just going to flounder and die. So will our planet, and so will we.